Hi folks, my name is Mario Peach, and in the first video today I showed you the basic steps how you can contribute with the to improve the TillWiki documentation. So I did show the basic step with the GitHub web UI, but I didn't explain the GitHub UI in general. So this video should be for new users that are not familiar with the GitHub web UI. So I did click the Jeremlin link here, and it opens Jeremy's repositories, or GitHub account in this case. So there you can see these popular repositories, which is TillWiki 5, the Tilly desktop, and so on. Some statistics, what's going on. So I click to TillWiki 5. There we have the overview with the source, all the subdirectories, the main files, readme, and so on, what you can see here. So we are at the code tab at the moment. There we have an overview about the commits. So commits basically show what's going on. So Jeremy did tweak some 2 hours ago, the coding style tweaks. Okay, if I click it, I can see what was changed. And then there is a merge pull request from BuggyJ with some additional information. Then there is also the pull request which I did some hours ago. If you have a look here again, this is just one line with there will be a video soon, so which is the other one. So I'll come back to this later, and so on, so you can see what's going on. What else is there? There are some branches, it's just an overview, not that is interesting. But then there are the releases, so every release can be tagged with a version tag, so it's the same as what was published on tillwiki.com. So you can download the source here with a zip file or a tar.gzip file. Okay, back to tillwiki 5. Then contributors and so on, some statistics. Then there is the issue tab, where you can file bugs and improvements and feature requests and all this stuff, and the things can be discussed with everyone which is signed in. Okay, issues. Then the next one is the pull requests. There we have pull requests. There are 18 open pull requests and there are closed pull requests, and one of the closed pull requests is the one from me 2 hours ago, and there I can see, okay, this is going on. I'm not signed in at the moment, so I'll sign in. Then I can see that my pull request was successfully merged, so the PMario patch 1, which is merged, and since this branch in my PMario directory or PMario repository is not needed anymore, I can delete it. So I have a look here with my account. So now I'm at PMario TillWiki 5, and there still is the branch patch 1. But I don't need this branch anymore, so I can say delete it. Okay, that's done. If I do a refresh here, refresh the page, my patch 1 is gone. So there has been already a question, what happens with the feature branches when you successfully merged it. Then you have the possibility to delete it. And the other branches, so if I'm back to PMario, I have the possibility here, I can see branches. And if I have write access, I can delete them. So write access, I can even create them. So I say, okay, test, enter. Now this created a test branch. Starting from my actual master branch, it created a test branch. There is also a visual overview about the branches, which can be seen at the graphs directory. So if I have a look at graphs, there I get different statistics and so on, and there is one, the one which I work most, is called networks. And there you can see there are my branches. There is not updated yet, so I say Shift F5. Okay, now you can see it because I did delete the patch 1 branch already. But you still can see it. So this is the patch 1 branch, and there is the test now, which I created from master. There you can see all the other contributors that have forked the repository and so on. So this is the view, how it looks like from my overview. If we go back to Jeremy, I also have a graphs view. Where's that here? Graphs. Then I can say network. Shift F5. Update it. And then you can see this is how it looks like from Jeremy's repository. He has merged my patch, and I merged his master branch, and now I created the test branch. So what was going on? This is very interesting. So there was something. What's here? This is the German translation that I made. Then here is Bram Chen. This is the Chinese translation. So if I click here, then I can see what he did. Changes, deleting stuff and adding stuff. So this is, let's say, one of the most interesting overviews. This is the graphs overview, where you can see which branches are existing. Okay, let's go back. What else is there? We have the pull requests. Yeah, there is a possibility for a wiki, but we have tilwiki.com. That's basically the most interesting parts. Yeah, what still is there? There is you can star repositories, which is like a like in Facebook. So if you don't have started, then just star the information and get Jeremy on top of the hit list. Yeah, that's basically it for the overview about the UI. I hope it will help you. Have fun.